When the Home Office attacks,
we fight back.
When the Home Office attacks,
we fight back.
When the Home Office attacks,
we fight back.
When Theresa May attacks,
we fight back.
When Theresa May attacks,
we fight back.
We have seen people deported for over 30, 40 years. People have been denied entry into their own country. People have been disallowed to return to the United Kingdom. People have been disenfranchised from their families, their friends, and their homes. People have lost their houses. People have lost everything because of a racist government policy that means the color of your skin determines whether or not you can enter the United Kingdom. And if they get away with it, if we allow them to get away with injustices like this, they will come again and they will take more liberties. They will take more from us every time. Look at what it costs to make an application for a child born in this country to have British citizenship. Over £1,000 for a child born in this country. The Home Office is making money off of children. They're exploiting our families for profit. They exploit us every time for profit. And we need to put a stop to this. We need to put a stop.
What you're doing, because we want love. All of us have love. All the black people that come here, there's only very few who think go to the way. But we work for you as a slave and we get no pay. So please pay we are. I thank you.
Like most immigrants, the children were taught you gotta work hard, you gotta work hard. And we were pretty well near the top of the class. But when the Windrush generation came, they were 2 years ahead of us because the schools in the Caribbean were so much better than the schools here. So in every subject at my school, you found that an African person or a Caribbean person, the terminology, I know lots of people prefer the term African, were top of the class. And of course the white elite couldn't stand this. If the children were brighter, that meant the next generation was going to be brighter. So what did they do? They imposed draconian measures that black people could not show their full potential. This has been going on for generations, not only my generation, I'm 69, but the generation afterwards and the generation afterwards.